So today I'm here to give you a walkthrough about Husky platform. So as we all know, Husky is a freelancer marketplace platform, just like Upwork and Fiverr. So I will explain you all the features about the admin dashboard, and I will also give you a walkthrough about all the features and how this platform works, how you can post the project, and how the bidding part works. So let's start this. So as you can see, it's a freelancer marketplace for the content writers. So now this is the admin dashboard. So we have so many tabs available here. So now if you want to just visit the site, the customer site, you can click on this option, review site. So it will give you will open the website on how it will look to the customers on anybody who will visit the website. So you can see how the website looks and feel. So under the billing section, you will find what is the plan that you have selected under this Husky. Now under the manage section, we have so many options given. The first one is users. So under the users section, you will be able to find all the users who have been listed on this platform. So irrespective of freelancers or in any project owners, they will all be available here. You will be able to find details of each and every users who are listed on the platform. So here you can see there are so many users who are listed here. Okay, and you can also restrict the rights given to them. Okay, suppose you don't want to give any rights of posting or bidding to anyone, you can just restrict it from here. And you can always make admin to any user. You have the right that you can make any user admin, and you can always ban any user as well, as if you find that there are certain users who are not frequent on the platform, or they're just not using the platform, or you want to ban them anytime, you have to just click on this option, it will ban. If you want to add any new user, you can just click on this option of add new user. Then you have to just put some details of the user you want to add, the email ID, first name, last name, and the account type, whether they are a freelancer or business owner. Then you can just select the location also if you want, and then you can add them from here. You can always export the list of the users from here. It will export the file in a CSV format, and you can always filter the users according to the filters we have given, like pending users or banned or the accepted ones. So you have the option to filter them by this option as well. Now after user section, we get to this project section. So under the project section, you will be able to find all the projects that have been posted on this platform. So as you can see, there are so many projects that has been posted on this platform. And if you want to check the biddings as well, you can just click on this option of bids. It will show you what all bids have been received on this projects. So being an admin, you have the rights to just check each and everything. So as you can see, there are so many projects posted, and if you want to filter according to the open or closed or expired projects, you can just select this option from here, and it will give a better idea about projects. Now under the transactions section, we will find all the transactions that are taking place on this platform, and what is the amount that's so suppose there is any transaction between the freelancers and the customers, so that will be just placed here. And with the help of conversations, we will be able to track all the chats and all the information that has been taking, that has been sharing between the customers, business owners, and the freelancers. So any kind of chat or any kind of conversations that is going on the platform between the freelancers and the business owner will be visible here. Suppose you want to email the users on the platform, you can always select this option of email users. With the help of email users, you can email all the users who are listed on the platform, or you have an option to select who all you want to send the emails. So you can select the listing from here and then post the emails to the clients. Now, with the help of invitations, you can invite new users from here as well. Thus, you can enter as many as email ID that you have. So it will give you an option to add a bulk number of users simultaneously. So you can add as many as email IDs as you want. You have to just separate them with a comma, and then you can enter a message here as well. Then you can invite from here. Now, this is a very interesting feature of promo codes, which gives, from settings option, you can always enable it, okay? And it gives you an option to just attract the persons who are visiting on your platform. So suppose you can see, enable promo code. So from here you can enable the promo codes feature, and once you enable it, you can use it also to attract the freelancers or the customers as well. You can always give them the promo code option, and suppose you want to give the freelancers that any freelancers who are just placing a bid of two or three projects in a month, so they will be able to use the promo code, or any kind of idea that you have. So this promo code really helps in it. So now, as we all know that we always want to design our website and the landing pages according to our need, and we all want to look very attractive. Okay. So with the help of this configure section, we can just do all these things. As you know, under this configure section, the first one is basic details. So with the help of basic details, you can just select the languages, as you have multi languages available on the platform. You can choose any languages which are available in the drop down. And if you don't find any language that you want to add, you can always ask us. We will be doing it for you with the help of any customization. Okay. You can always select the freelancing platform name, the slogan that you want to give. And the descriptions, and you can always edit the search box as well, what you want to enter in the search box. So basically, this is the basic details that will be visible. Now, under the integration section, you will find a token. So if you want to integrate any delivery management system as well, so you can always enable token. That's an in-house product of JungleWorks. So moving on, now we have a section that's design. Okay, so this will give you a better look of the platform. You can always select the logo. You can select the logo for the applications of mobile, Android, and iOS applications. You can choose the cover photo as well. You can choose the favicon, and then any colors code that also you have in mind, you can always just select them from here. So, and now the most important thing, that is the landing page. So this is the section which helps you to give a feel and a good view of your website. So now, as you can see how we have created this landing page, what all sections are here, you can see. So here, this is the landing page that we have created for this content creators. Okay. And this is the main website. So all the projects that has been posted will come here. So there are so many sections that can be used while designing a landing page. So as you can see, we have a main section, info section, and then we have a footer, and we can always add any new section as well. Info sections with column, category section, video section, multiple listing, business category. So these are so many, there are so many categories that can be used while designing a landing page. So if you have anything in your mind and you want your website to be similar like any other website, so that all ideas can be used with the help of these options. Now we have given you options of themes as well to look platform more attractive. So we have two themes that will be available free of cost. One, this is a paid theme, the premium one, which comes with a subscription. Once you take any subscription with our Jungle Books, then you will be able to use this premium theme. Now we can always customize the top bar as well, what all we want to put there in the top bar. As you can see, we have given these options like invite members, contact us, and then home services. So anything apart from these things you want to add, we have the option of add a new link to the menu. You just add a new link and then you can enter the URL also. So this was the top bar section. So you can add many more contents on the top bar as well. So in the footer section, you can give your descriptions of all the your social login, social pages, like you have Facebook, we have Twitter, Instagram, YouTube. So you can always enter the URL of these social links in the footer section. As you can see, here we have selected this Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn. They all are already here. So you can always add them with the help of this footer section. Now come to user field section. In the user field section, this is the section which gives us the option to add any new fields while signing in or freelancers or project owners. So these are the fields that are already added into this section. Now if you want to add any new field, we have given you this option. Okay, as you can see, we have already added this location section as well. So the location can be added, the CV they have to upload, for the freelancers, suppose they want to join the platform, they have to upload their photo as well. These are all the sections that can be used. Now, so we can always add any new sections and any new fields in the user fields as well with the help of add a new field option. Now we move to the project category section. This is a very important section. So with the help of this category section, we can decide what all categories we want to give to our projects that are being posted on the platform. So here we can see we have as we are giving this platform for the content writers, so there are so many sections we have already added for this project categories, and we can always add any new category with the help of this create a new category option. Now, project fields and filters. So basically, while posting a project, what all options will be there once we post the project? So we can see there are project title, budget allocated. So there are always some default sections given. So if you want to add any new fields on this, so you have the option of this customizing this section as well. Now, with the help of project fields template, you get an option to give a better understanding about the projects. Okay, suppose you the client, the customers and the business owners, while they are posting a project and they want to give some specific detailed idea about the platform and the project they are posting. So this section gives them a better leverage to give a detailed reception about their projects. Now, project bid fields gives you the option of once the bidding part is done by the freelancers. So these all sections will be there that have to be filled by them, by the freelancers while making a bid. If you want to add any new sections to this, we have given you the option of that thing also. We have this rating and reviews options as well. So once the job is done by the freelancer, so the rating and reviews will be given by the customers, the business owners. So that gives a better understanding to the other customers using the platform. Once they join any freelancer, they can just check the reviews and rating section, and they can decide on the kind of a work that they want to do with the freelancers. Now, this project type, this section gives you what all type of projects that you want. So there can be project with online payment, project without online payment. Okay, now, and as we have, you can see we have two sections here, cash projects and projects with online payment. So we can always add some more categories to this. Social media gives you an option to log in this platform with the help of your social media accounts. So suppose we have Facebook and we have Gmail and we have other social media accounts. So we can always log in with the help of those social logins as well. So suppose I want to give them my users an option to log in with their Twitter handle or Facebook account. So we can always just put the details here, and once the clients will be going to join this platform, they have the leverage to join this with their social logins as well. I will just give you an example of this as well. So I'm just opening this in a new window, and then I will try to join this platform. So once just give me a moment. Now you can see this is the content creators platform. Now suppose I want to sign up, you can see it is asking for the account type. Suppose I want to work. So you can see here, we can always log in with the help of this Facebook account as well, as we have already given that option of social media logins. Or so this is the benefit of using this section. Now, content pages is also a very important feature which helps to just as you can see, we have selected this about us and certain things. So suppose you want to add any new so these are the sections which are already there. So where it should be redirected, what all the commands you should be giving. So I suppose there is a section about us. Okay, now if you want to add any new section, so that can be done with the help of footer. Okay, so if we go to, so I will give you an example here that will give you a better idea of what I'm saying. Suppose I go to the footer section. Okay, now terms and conditions are not mentioned here, so I will add a new link to the footer. Now once I will go to this option, now once I will refresh this page, it will give me one more option of terms and conditions. Now where I want this to be redirected, once I click on this option of terms and conditions, that I can decide with the help of this section, that is content pages. So I will go to the section of content pages, and now again I will add a so here we can add terms and conditions. With the help of this section, and then we can redirect that page to any other page that we want to get. So this was the basic options that were very important to understand. Now I will show you how the project is posted and how the bidding part is done. So here we can see with the help of this post the project button, we can post a new project. Suppose I want a content writer, I will post the project. Suppose I'm going for a cash project. I want to give any detailed description, I can always give that. Any skills required, I suppose I want any skills required as well. Our experience level is the most important thing that gives me leverage to select the experience level as well. Now what's the budget that I want, I'm looking for? Suppose I'm looking for a budget of Now, suppose I have any image also to reflect my project type. So that I can choose from here. So any image I can attach to this project to give a better idea about my requirement. It takes a bit of time. So now I'll post the project. So we can see the project is posted now. Project created successfully. Now if I want to make a bid on this project, so I will again go to this option and log in as a freelancer. Then only I will be able to Now moving to the freelancer section, as you can see, I have logged in a separate window with this freelancer account. So this is the project that we just posted, looking for a blogger. So now as a freelancer, I want to make a bid on this project. So I will just go and check the project. So this is a freelancer account, and this is the project that we just posted, looking for a blogger. So as a freelancer, now I want to place a bid on this. Previously, this place a bid option was not visible because the admin didn't give the right to this freelancer to post a bidding. Now as I have given a right to the freelancer, so now the freelancer can make a bid on this project. So with the help of this place a bid option, I will just bid for this project. Now as the project is for 11,000 rupees, suppose I think that this job is for 15,000 and the timeline required will be 10 days. And cover letter, suppose I want to give that I can also mention. So you can see the bidding part is done. Now again, moving on to the project section, I will see that once the bidding is done, the notification will be sent to the business owner that there has been a bidding. As you can see, bid has been created. Placement has been placed, and there will be a chat notification as well that will be coming to them. So now we can just check for the bids that are there on this project. So we can see this is the bid that we have received. Now as the bid that the project was for 11,000 rupees and the freelancer has asked for a 15,000 amount, so we can always revise the amount as well. Suppose you want to revise this amount, so we will approve this. If you think that this is a freelancer deserving 15,000 rupees, we can always accept his demand, and we can update the bidding amount. So we have updated the bidding amount as 15,000. Now again, the freelancer will have to approve this updated bidding. So here the freelancer will go in the settings, and under the settings section, the projects he has bidded for, that can be seen here. So this is the project looking for a blogger. So he want to approve this. Now the bid amount status has been updated. So, now we can see this is approved. If you want to chat directly with the freelancer, that can also be done. So it has been accepted, and both the parties have involved have started the project. Now, being a business owner, suppose I want to create a milestone for my kind of job, so I can just always enter the milestone. Any description I want to give, or if I want to pay any amount after the first milestone is completed. Suppose I want to make a payment of 5,000 or after the first milestone is completed, I can just put a detailed description what all I am expecting in the first milestone. So once it's done, I will save this. So the freelancer will be updated that the milestone has been created. So once he completes the milestone, the part of payment that is attached to this milestone will be paid to the freelancer. Basically, this was the flow where we understood how it can be done, how the bidding part is done, how the projects are posted, okay, and how we can just design the landing page and all the other features. So I hope this must have given you all a better understanding about the platform Husky. Okay, and there are always integrated payment gateways as well, like Stripe, PayPal, and Rozier Pay for UPI payments. And we always welcome any new kind of payment gateways as well. So if you have any requirement, you can always customize and give them those payment gateways. So I hope I have just covered all the points required in this Husky walkthrough. Thank you so much for your time.